I guess the discussion, I don't know, has been kind of redirect. We're having all this liberal disquaint, like, oh my god, I guess I'm going extinct, I'm endangered for that feeling. I'm just feeling endangered. And yet here we have all of a sudden the point to the borders. Everybody, let's look at the Mexican American border. And that seems like, well, that's been going on for a long, long time, and it's there. And we have to fix it right now. Before everybody starts saying we're building walls, for what purpose? For what purpose? Just as a catch prisoners on one side or the other? I already made that if you're gonna go the wall route to make the no man's land of the 50 miles and you charge a fee either direction. I already made that that's a video a long time ago. But when we're talking about if you want to mimic the EU, and that in that 50 miles it was going to be the self-sustaining new technologies, those types of things for housing. So it was going to be a very interesting Mexican-American meeting place. With a train, yeah, a train that actually takes people from Mexico into America and from America back into Mexico. So it was going to be very expensive. Also, it was going to cost you $50 for the journey. So that was my route. Was if you're going to do this, you're going to do it right, and you're going to make a no man's land, and you're going to actually do something in that no man's land, and you're going to have the best of construction methodologies for that southwest region, and that will be like its test bed for all of the desert southwest, etc. Now, but instead, that's with the wall version. That's my wall version. If you're gonna do a wall version, it would be a no man's land that is self-sustainable and a learnable subject of area. Now, when we're going away from the wall, let's go back to the EU. Oh, that's wonderful. It's wonderful. Let's add another country into the EU. Just add them in like the North American EU. Let's add them in, and that'll be sweet. And add Canada also. So we just walk across the borders, everything's great and swell, and we just walk all the way to Mexico, and we don't even need to take our passport, and we're just feeling like we don't need a driver's license. We're like, this is great. Until we're there looking at, uh-oh. That also means any industry that wants can take its little self in a truck and can go into Mexico and make it just look like garbage really quick. Oh, we'll upgrade it. We'll upgrade Mexico. We'll make it look wonderful, like little cutesy Riviera communities. Well, that's sweet, but on the other token shelf, there's a lot of the ugly, cruddy businesses that will head down there, and they'll bring every little cruddy little truck, every little cruddy little construction business, and it'll just be a mess. It'll be a mess of industry that starts and creates and housing communities. It'll just be a nightmare in a way. So, because there is not zoning, you know, it would have to be the most tight zoning to make it beautiful. It's like, hey, let's move to the interior and we'll set up a beautiful American camp. Well, it's going to have some very beautiful zoning. But if you just open up the borders and just say, hey, everybody rush across either way, there's not going to be zoning. And it's going to make a pit of Mexico even further. And it's not necessarily going to help the financial situation. It won't be like, hey, you get your 10% or your 30% increase in your yearly wage. It's not going to help that. I don't see that as helping that. I think that is just like, why plunder your country into just, I would call it an eyesore ruin. It would just absolutely be an eyesore ruin of new builds, just for the sake of new builds, cheap new builds, and that's what it would be. So you open up Mexico, like an EU next door neighbor, it would just be cheap construction. And it would be a, what do you call that when they're just grabby for it, grabby for that quick cash. Oh yeah, here's a house for $50,000. Get your house for $50,000, everybody, and move to Mexico. So they'll bring those communities. They'll start those up, and it's. Doesn't mean they're going to be built right. It doesn't mean they're going to be zoned correctly. It's not going to solve any disassociation problems with the poverty level. It's still going to be a poor state of Mexico. It's still going to be like, hey, great, I get my maid really cheaply. I get my servants really cheaply. That's still going to be going on. The divide sector, where it's like the wage is going to just even out, it'll take years and years and years. And in the meantime, they'll just be taken advantage of and taken advantage of and taken advantage of. Okay, the Mexican, they won't even be Mexican Americans, they could stay as Mexicans. And over there, you can stay as Americans. But yeah, that would be the EU version. Because you can look at that right now. You can look at Bulgaria. We'll look at Bulgaria in the EU, and we will look at France. Okay, so we look at Bulgaria, and they have houses maybe 25,000. They shot up to maybe 80,000. Now, that was brought on by the British. The British ran over there, and they bought much of Bulgaria quite cheaply, and so they did that, and they started constructing. All right, so they tried to level Bulgaria with France, and it didn't work. It did not work. What happened instead is France shot up, and Bulgaria just took its 80, instead of 25, it went to 80, and France, instead of its 150, went up to 300,000 or 400,000. So it actually did not level at all. What happened is it just was an increase in prices on the other side. So you will end up with an increase of prices on the American side. Like, I don't want to live down there. It's still disjointed. It's still a mess. No, I'm going to live here, and I'll pay 600,000. So that's what's going to happen in America, and then you'll get your 50,000 or you'll get your $75,000 house down there, new builds, but you know, it's still going to be a piteous circumstance because there's not going to have the zoning, and you're still dealing with Mexico. You're still dealing with the Mexican experience. You understand? So the Mexican experience will always be different from the American experience. Like they had all these people buying in Bulgaria, and they got out. They didn't want to be there anymore. And all these other ones would just freshly buy in again. So it's become a churn factor. So it's not necessarily a happiness, go buy and build there. It's just going to become a churn factor for a while. Anyway, I just thought it was a great opportunity, since there's so much strife between either was to actually have the self-sufficiency area of we, you know, go everything straw bale, go everything cob, walls, do everything adobe, really wholeheartedly. And only allow those construction mechanisms, only allow rainwater harvesting as a 50-mile no man's land between Mexico and America. And that was going to be a new hello. So it would be a modernization between the two countries rather than there's a fence and there's police with their whatever bayonets to kick you off of it. You know, instead of that tactic, which apparently is what they're saying, that type of thing instead. Which is really kind of, I guess you can go look at the Berlin Wall, like that was great, and then like what, in like 12 years, tear down the wall, Gorbachev, all of that. Is that what we're trying to recreate? Is that what's going on with this new talk of a wall? Tear down that wall, Gorbachev, rather than, you know, make something better. No, that hasn't helped, by the way. Germany has been thrust into the worst poverty than it has ever known. You took down that wall. It was just a nightmare. It's been bad for the arts. It's been bad for all kinds of businesses. Germany was thrust into a downward slide on the DAX for many, many years, and it's still trying to recoup. So, no, tearing down that wall after the fact isn't good either on a financial scale. So what we're looking at is wall builders that they want to be, hey, 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 a Gorbachev, or we want to look at an EU mimicker, where you just walk across and unfortunately create really bad cheap housing that people don't really want to live in, because it's still Mexico. It is still Mexico. So if you want America in Mexico, you have to alter the entire government. You have to alter it completely so it is a mimic exact of America. Then you'll be happy. All those Americans that want the cheap price will then be happy. But as long as it's not a mimic, as soon as Mexico stays and remains Mexico and there's a mordida there possible, you are going to have another experience. And so it's not going to be like EU, where it's just France and you're just moving from France to Germany. It's not going to be like that. It will be vast, like moving from France to Bulgaria. All right? Very many differences in cultures, very many differences in, hey, you know, this is really our turf still. That exists all over the EU. It's really our turf. That nationalism exists, and it's thick. It's thick all across the EU. So it is not, hey, 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 everybody. You know, it's good for a political, like, a raw moment. Everybody's like, yay, 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 out there going, this is wonderful. But in reality, when it comes down to it, it's a nationalistic, you better really like that country, you better like those people, because you really are still in France, you really are still in Spain, you really are still in Bulgaria. And if you open up the Mexico the same way, you will really still be in Mexico, no matter how many new builds all of a sudden happen. So anyway, that's my take on it, and I don't really, you know, it's a tough, what do we call it? It's a tough, when we have such a difference between America and Mexico, such a disparity, such a difference, you know. Yeah, I would rather the two actually make something beautiful together. Rather than start building an ugly wall, make something beautiful there, you know, and go ahead and charge a price. Go ahead and charge a price. I'm not a problem with that. Why not? Add $50 onto every flight. Add $50 onto to every car travel from America to Mexico, and vice versa, and do something there. I just think it's going to be a disaster to go and build this encampment wall without actually making a commitment to the Mexican people, making a commitment to Mexico, making a commitment to Americans that there's going to be something better there. That is good for both sides. I don't know. That was my methodology with it a long time ago, and I guess I'm going to stick to it. I'm going to stick to that new wave of thought. You know, live the no man's land, and certain people from Mexico could live there, and certain people from America could live there, but they would be chosen people, be special people that were special and chosen, whether from universities, professors, the students, certain people that have that type of what do you call it? Yeah, we got to get going with our housing methodologies. We just have to. We have way too many people here on this planet. We have got to develop better housing methodologies. Ones that are sustainable, ones that are not always running to a forest, ones that are not always running to concrete. So yeah, those are our priorities. Mexico and America. So yeah. Anyhoot, what was the deal? Yeah, so I'm against the wall unless it's a structurable event for this sustainability, and that would be two walls, and yeah, of 50 miles across all across the United States border and the Mexican border, U.S. and Mexico. That's sweet. I would think that would be sweet. I think people will jump at that and think that would be great. Also, there was another thing, the other version that I was discussing was the proliferation of new cruddy new build communities that would occur, and I'll say cruddy new build communities because they're not even building them here properly in America, so yeah, it'll just be just a what do you call that? Eugh. Yeah, and we don't even want to talk about mobile home upstarts, okay, because that would go on also. Alrighty, everybody. Yeah, just move all of the poverty Americans, just move them down there. I don't know, I'm just kind of sick of that as a let's open up the EU America style with Mexico. Yeah, that's what would happen. And unfortunately, a lot of the poverty American style are not... not high up on the totem poles of class, so that wouldn't go over very well either. We'll end up with extra prisons in Mexico, just trying to detain the insubordinate Americans. Okay, alrighty, enough of that. Anyway, so here I am, liberal, and I'm feeling absolutely like, I guess that's it. Vegetarians only. I don't even want to sit next to a carnivoric person any longer. I'm just getting so sick of all of you.